Hi, this is the third tutorial of simple parametric family. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to set parameters on pyramidal form. Let's start with new family. I'm going to use generic model adapter. Okay. If you don't know what is parametric family, why it is used, and how they will help you, you can read my blog for that. You will find the link in my description. Let me know what do you think about my blog. Let's start with reference level. For the pyramidal form, I will start with rectangle shape by using reference lines. Reference lines using rectangle. I'm going to create a rectangle. Pyramidal form has a square shape base and a square shape top. So I'm going to set the parameter for base and top squares. I need to set the rectangle to the center and fix its center points. I'm going to centralize this rectangle by using dimensions. The same way as I have shown in my first tutorial of the series. I'm using align dimension. Select the left line, select the middle line, and select the right line. Click this not equal symbol to equally divide the rectangle around the middle line. Again, using dimension, select the first line, select the middle line, and select the left line. Click this not equal symbol. Pressing escape to release modifier panel. I will need to add more dimensions to set the parameters. I'm going to add dimension for length. Select the first line and select the other line. Okay. For width, select the first line and select the other line. Pressing escape to release modifier panel. Select the dimension to add parameters to it. I'm going to name the parameter base. Okay. For pyramidal form, we need a square shape. Select this dimension and add the same parameter that we have created. This parameter will make both sides equal. You can see both sides are equal to 14 feet 6 inches. Now I'm going to create a solid form. Select the reference line and create a solid form. Okay. Our basic form is ready for pyramidal form. I'm going to check the parameter. I'm going to change the size to 10 feet. Apply. You can see the size is changed. Parameter is working. Now I'm going to select the top surface of cube. You can see the top surface is locked. It means if I change the parameter of base, the top surface will change as well. But if I unlock the top surface and then I change the surface to 20 feet, the result will be different. You see, the base is changed to 20 feet, but top surface is the same. I'm going to set the parameter for this top surface. Go to top view. I'm going to apply the dimensions to the top surface. Turn on the wireframe. From drop menu, select the align dimension. Select the left line, select the middle line, select the right line, and click the symbol. Click this line, select the middle line, and select the last line. Click this symbol to equally divide the line. I'm adding length to and width. I'm adding parameter to this dimension. I'm going to name it top. To maintain this square shape, I will need to apply the same parameter to this dimension. Okay. Now let's check the parameters again. I'm going to change the top to 15 feet. Size is changed. I'm going to change the base to 15 feet and top to 8 feet. Apply. Changing top to 6 feet again. Apply. Parameter for base and top is set. Now let's set the parameter for height. I'm going to elevation. To set the parameter for height, select the align dimension. Select the base and top surface. Select this dimension and apply a parameter. I'm going to name the parameter height. Let's check parameters. Let's change the height to 8 feet. See, top to 4 feet. Apply. Changing top to 2 feet again. Height to 6 feet. Base to 10 feet. Apply. This is how you set the parameter for pyramidal form. My next video of this series is how to set parameters for shell form. That's it.